as Hotazo Ledwaba.
And we moved to Mamelodi. The situation was difficult. Eating was a problem. We just lived for the next day. I know some phenomenal people, rich people. They live a very luxurious life. But they believe that everyone out there is okay with their lives. They have no idea what people go through. And you can never truly know what someone goes through until in its presence. All the time, I just wanted a solution. A solution that will take my mother out of this, my siblings out of this, me, those township boys that were coming after me, that were giving me a hard time. I also wanted them to stop living that life. My mother's prayers and my desire to live a better life helped me get the keys for this life. I received a bursary that took me to a school that changed my life entirely. It was unbelievable to get a bursary at a prestigious school such as this. Maybe for you, it might have been normal, but for me, it wasn't. I couldn't believe it.
Thank you, God. Thank you.
To be successful, you need to overcome certain challenges. You go through your own obstacles. Well, my challenges were a bunch of boys back where I come from, in the township. They bullied me, they teased me, they beat me up, but they built me. I wrote everything from that paper that I could remember. Childhood. I went to the school, and the first person I saw, I approached him. All I could think of was how scared I was, how shy I was. I thought he was gonna ask me, what am I doing here? What's your business here? Who are you? There was something in his eyes. There was warmth in his eyes. He smiled at me and he was calm and caring. All I could see was him welcoming, because the door that I was finally waiting for to open had opened. And I ran towards those eyes. And that man that took my paper, that man that helped me, was my class teacher.
I never forgot that day. It was my first year of teaching. He was the first student that arrived. When I saw that paper, I saw innocence. I saw faith in those eyes. Yes, he didn't say any word, but his heart was kind of talking to me, telling me everything. School started, everything was all right, but
I still had the challenges I have had before. It's like they were following. At times, I felt as if I was living in between two lives, where one was light and one was dark. When everyone had lunch, I just had water. And on my way home, I found a lunchbox. It was nothing big. It was empty, but it lightened my heart. So I could come to school and pretend I was eating something. So it really saved me.
He had some difficulties with his homework. It was clear that there was a problem. So I decided to visit his house so I can understand. That day was really tough for me. That life, that tough life. So I don't even remember how did I come back to home. I started to take better care of him, and I began following up on him. It was Friday. He didn't come to school. He was absent. And on Monday, when I heard that he didn't come again, I went to his house. When I found out the reason behind him not coming to school, thank you.
Sorry about that. My deepest condolences.
I felt very guilty on that day. Why didn't I go on Friday or Saturday? If I did go, maybe I would have done something. I still feel guilty that I brought him to dormitory. But I thought there are thousands of lives which need to be saved just like this. As a school, we discuss a lot about what we could do to save more lives. So we came with the idea of community outreach programs that when we started implementing Gift of Hope, parents and teachers reacted sincerely in terms of donations, and they are still helping a lot. I can never thank them enough. In a nutshell, Comfort finished high school successfully and attended the university, became a teacher in our school. Currently, he is the director of the Gift of Hope programs.
Helping people has always been my dream. And by coming to this school, I managed to secure that dream. There are many other schools out there that help other people. This is Africa. There are a lot of people out there that require support, that need help, that need schools like this. And to those schools out there, I say thank you. I thank the dedicated teachers, those that sacrifice their lives for the good of others. Life continues with love. So we need to hold the hands of people who need love, because life continues with love.